Hey everyone, this is Dr. Sekruin here at Performance Sport and Spine, and today's video will be discussing knee osteoarthritis, better known as knee OA. So osteoarthritis is a multifactorial condition characterized by joint pain, stiffness, and structural changes, most commonly in the knee joint, but also affects hips, hands, and shoulders. So historically, we kind of thought of this disease as this mechanical wear and tear, your bones just kind of grinding on each other, wearing out your body. Well, it turns out there's a lot more going on, which is fortunate because there's a lot of things that we can control. So how do you know you have knee arthritis? Well, some signs and symptoms can help. First, are you over the age of 50? Do you have morning stiffness less than 30 minutes? Crepitus during range of motion, which is kind of crackling or popping in your joint. Is there tenderness along the joint? Do you have bony enlargement? And then lastly, there should be no increase in temperature as this is indicative of other arthropathies. So what are first line interventions for knee arthritis? Well, it turns out that all people are recommended to exercise, education on the subject, and weight loss when appropriate. And again, this is all people, not everyone that's not having surgery. All people dealing with this condition will benefit from these. If you'd like to pause the video, we've listed in more detail how to accomplish these goals in each area. So wear and repair, and you heard me right, it's not wear and tear, it's wear and repair. As we stress the body and give it adequate time to recover and adapt, the body gets stronger and better handles those stresses and loads. And it's no different with knee OA. Again, a lot of times when people feel pain, they think of it as damage, and it's much more due to sensitivity or irritation that can be managed and built upon. In addition, moderate exercise and activity has found to be safe and beneficial for the effects of the knee, and inactivity or sedentarism tends to be associated with greater cartilage thinning. So again, rest is rust. If your knee hurts and you don't use it all, it gets weaker. So you have to find an entry point and then build upon. So the biggest takeaway is finding the right dosage for activity or exercise is safe with knee OA and can actually help decrease pain and improve function. So to kind of help clarify this, we're going to look at this exercise envelope. So if you look at the graph here, you can see that on the x-axis, it's time, and on the y-axis, it's exercise or load. And on this blue line, it's the minimum exercise or activity the body needs to stay healthy, and this red line is the maximum amount. You need to stay between these two lines. So if you look at the point A, this person is sedentary, and they don't get the minimum stimulus, so the body is kind of unhealthy and decrepit. And this person in point B does way too much, way too fast. Now, point C person is in between these two lines, and as you see time goes on, you can do more overall load and your margin of error gets bigger. So again, you have to start kind of slow and safe, but pretty soon you can open up things and build upon. So with knee arthritis, with starting exercise or movement, you're gonna feel some pain or discomfort. So kind of knowing what's safe and what not is helpful. An analogy that I find really helpful with my patients is the traffic light, red, yellow, and green. So green light is go. Maybe a little bit of discomfort during, but nothing lasting, and you're just going, you're having fun, no worries there. Red light is severe pain, greater than 5 out of 10, and often it's associated with like limping or night pain, or the wake up the next day and your knees are just aching. That's too much, too fast, you need to reassess. Now, most of you live in the yellow, which is moderate to mild pain, 2 to 4 out of 10. Now, again, this is variable to the person, but basically what the parameters are here is the pain should be mild during the activity. It should settle down within 24 hours and you should have no night pain at night and it shouldn't really disrupt your day. So if you're going about your day and your knees are sore 3 out of 10, but you don't really think about it and you wake up the next morning, you're like, hey, I'm back to my baseline, go ahead and proceed. Now, again, if you don't feel pain during, but you feel some pain the next morning, that's your body saying, hey, you pushed a little too hard and you want to give yourself an extra day or two's rest until you're back to baseline to proceed again. So now we're going to go over the exercise portion. We broke them out into non-weight bearing and weight bearing, and we'll try to show you ways to progress and regress them so you can individualize them to your current level. And again, there's lots of different exercises that you can do. Research has shows that anything from Tai Chi to swimming can help. So find something that you enjoy, that's goal oriented, and that helps socially. So band and knee extension. So anchor the band behind you and put the strap around your ankle. On a step, make mild tension at rest. Contracting your anterior part of your leg, your quad, straighten your knee fully, and then bring back to starting position. Again, as you contract your quad, you should feel gentle tension over your anterior leg, and you should think about pulling your kneecap up towards your hip. We're gonna do 2 sets of 10 to 12 reps to increase the difficulty, get a stiffer band, or pull the band farther back behind you. To decrease the difficulty, you may just start with just your body weight or a less stiff band. If you need to, you can use a different band like we demonstrate here, that's smaller, or an ankle weight will also work. Band and knee flexion. Anchor one aspect of the band away from you. Place the other aspect around your ankle. Pull your foot under your buttocks in a seated position. You should feel gentle, dull tension on the posterior leg or your hamstring. Again, try to make full range of motion and straighten your leg all the way and bring your foot back as far as possible. We recommend 2 sets of 10 to 12 reps. To increase the difficulty, get a stiffer band or anchor farther away from you. To decrease the difficulty, use a less stiff band or just your body weight. Seated clamshell, so in a seated position, put the band around your knees. And then using your glutes, press your knees outwards against the resistance of the band, slow and controlled, and back. We recommend 2 sets of 10 to 12 reps, 3 to 4 times a week. To increase the difficulty, make a more stiff band and place it around your legs. To decrease the difficulty, use a less stiff band or simply just use your body weight initially. So glute bridge, laying on your back with your knees bent and your feet flat on the floor, using your butt and hip muscles, you're gonna drive up towards the ceiling and down. Make sure to feel it in your butt and hamstrings and not your back. If you are, you can press your back against the floor and drive up. We'll also link a different video that can help address this with different cues. Again, the tension should be in your hip and buttocks. We recommend 2 sets of 10, 3 to 4 times a week. Horizontal slide, so with the band anchored again around one ankle and then opposite side, put your foot on a slider. If you don't have a slider, you can use like a washcloth on a hardwood floor, and you're gonna press your leg to the opposite direction, feeling tension on this hip and coming back. Now, since we're dealing with knee OA, you wanna lean into the wall and make sure you emphasize loading your hip first and not your knee. Work on increasing the range of motion as you feel comfortable and your symptoms allow. We recommend 2 sets of 6 to 8 reps with this and increase as you feel tolerance. Box squat, so have a box behind you, cross your arms and sit down, loading your hips and keeping your weight over your midfoot. Now this is the most challenging of this series, so there's a couple of variations that we can do that will demonstrate the end of this. Again, as you squat down, load your hips and keep your weight over your midfoot. Try hard not to lean forward or lean your torso forward. We recommend 2 sets of 6 to 10 reps, 3 times a week. Now a couple of variations that we can do is make the box higher so we can reduce the range of motion, or you can do a ball wall squat to build strength and then transfer this later. So we want to talk about this important randomized controlled trial for knee OA that compared a group that had physical therapy versus a group that had injections. And at 1 year follow-up, the group with physical therapy had less pain and functional disability compared to the injection group. So the big takeaway here is injections may help with pain management, but the primary intervention should be exercise, education, and weight control to help the person self-manage and improve their capacity over the long term. So some other treatments are topical and oral NSAIDs that are recommended in this first-line intervention for those that don't have comorbidities. And injections have their time and place for pain management, but should only be used in conjunction with exercise, education, and weight loss. So unfortunately, only about 30% of patients that have OA receive appropriate care following the guidelines. And there's a call for individualization of multidimensional approach to assess and treat that emphasize self-management strategies. So for imaging, x-rays and MRIs do have some clinical utility, but it's important to note there's a lack of association between pain and knee x-rays. And this is due probably to the different demographics, the definition of pain, and the number of views for the x-rays. So the big takeaway here is this diagnosis is more than just someone taking an x-ray of your knee and telling that you have knee arthritis. So surgery can be a viable option for end-stage knee OA, and knee replacements have been shown to be very successful with helping people in pain. However, 20% of people will still have pain after the knee replacement. Thank you so much for watching our video on knee OA. It turns out there's a lot of cheap and simple things that we can do to help decrease people's pain and suffering. If you found this video helpful, please like our video and subscribe to our channel as it helps us reach a larger audience.